I think success here comes from a lot of things. You've got to believe. For me, it was a dream. This was the only race. This was the event that got me into triathlon.
Building your entire year around Hawaii, and that means setting up a proper race schedule and then doing all the small details that are important to performing in Hawaii.
There's no event like Kona because there's no event that exposes you to the elements as much as this race does. It's one thing to be in exceptional swim, bike and run form, but how your body handles the elements of heat, wind, humidity. When you're in a spa or a sauna, that rock that you tip the water on, that's lava rock. So, you know, it's the ambient air temperature out in those lava fields that make it horrible.
You get a very good sense early on that you are at the mercy of this island. There's going to be no favours on race day. You're going to have to work for every inch on that course.
Once the gun goes off, you know, it's fighting for a position. There's like our elbows and feet in your face, and it gets pretty rough.
The bike ride is windy and hot and lonely. Also beautiful in its own way. It has a bit of climbing, some rollers, some flat sections that are fast.
The most difficult part is the wind. That can make a small hill into a mountain.
When you're out on the run, you have a lot of time to be inside your own head, and you do have fans and other things on the side of the road, but there's a lot of stretches of open highway. It's desolate, stark.
It is a lonely place. Dropping down into the energy lab, obviously, you know, that's historically a graveyard of fallen heroes.
It's gonna take a really good day, swim, bike, and run, but I think ultimately it's gonna take a day where you get through those hard parts in the best way possible.